All right, guys, I want to share with you guys some interesting comment here. So this guy, Zach Hill, mentioned that on episode 57, I said, you can now wield a legend spaceship, even though I'll never get that. So episode 57 was clearly a very long time ago, because I'm on like episode 180. And I don't remember saying that. And I actually went back to episode 57 just to see what the heck he's talking about.
So okay, hopefully I can get maybe one to
so
two more
levels. So the next clip,
we'll see.
I should be getting
and
75.
And here
yeah.
is 75 prayer. Right, pretty nice.
Go.
Ooh, I can wield a legend spirit shield.
Shield. Okay.
Never going to get this on the Ironman. Maybe. Anyways.
Alright, so I said I'll never get this on the Ironman. Maybe. Yeah, I think at that time I was like, the chance of me getting a legend was probably very unlikely. In present time, I actually do have the legend, which was very unexpected for me. So that was a long time ago, man. We made some crazy progress, guys. So the Dragon Hunter crossbow got buffed today. So it used to be 10% accuracy and damage against dragons, but now it's 30%, so 20% higher. And obviously this makes this very interesting, as in, where could I use this, you know, and benefit from it? I'm thinking forecast, right? So let's see, with all the modifiers except for the 30% damage against dragons, let's see how much damage I can do with this. 65, wow. So if 30% damage on top of dragons stacks with all of this, I'm supposed to theoretically hit 80 pluses with the dragon diamond bolt. So like at forecast specifically, because you know there's no dragons other than forecast that you can stack the salvage. So this will pretty much beat ballista at forecast, because yeah, I can max at 70. So the 30% accuracy from Giant Hunter crossbow will probably make it competitive in terms of accuracy. Yeah, maybe I should bring the buckler too then. Oh, what is that? A 74? I didn't even use the special attack. That's insane. Oh my god, what is that hit? A 72? Okay, that was without a spec, I'm pretty sure. You got everything, dude. Everything stacks. This place is stupid now. 119. 122 with Dragon Hunter crossbow as primary, so it definitely just competes with blowpipe by itself. I mean, with adamant. Oh my god, 448. Oh, I just hit 84, dude. That's freaking insane. I'm not sure if that's the max hit. 41 HP. Okay, let's eat up because poison might kill me. Elite clue scroll. All right. That was a pretty quick elite clue scroll. God damn. Alright, I think that's enough testing with the Dragon Hunter crossbow. So, a few things I would like to say. With the Dragon Hunter crossbow, at forecast specifically, this makes it comparable to that of blowpipe. But it's not really going to be like crazy OP like you see it at forecast, because you're not going to be fighting dragons elsewhere with the Salve Amulet EI. Alright, we just finished the forecast task. First forecast task, and yeah, that was pretty fun. I'm almost at 700 KC now. But yeah, 300 more kills and I'll have 1,000 for that. But I would like for my next PVM for the 1K goal to be for Zami boss. So hopefully I can get that right after this. Nada. Oh, Elite Clue Scroll. Well, it's time to do some clues then. Alright, I think that's good. Okay, so this master was from the latest forecast elite. Alright, here we go. Yeah, it's alright. It's an alright master. Hell yes. 182 greater demons, dude. I've been looking for this task for the past few days. Really excited to go back to Zambi because I have so much new gear to try out. So it's been quite a long time since I've done any of the God Wars bosses. Zami should particularly be very interesting, as I will be able to utilize a bunch of new equipment like Elysian, the Kodai, and a few other things that I didn't have before when I did God Wars over like a year ago. So there's going to be a lot of theory crafting going on, because I got some new experimental setups that I want to try. And as you can see here on the Zami, I have 423 KC. So I got a lot to do. Very excited. So I have been thinking about trying out something a little bit different than the usual method that I would do at Zami. So previously, I would do the standard, you know, Zami setup. I would use Protect from Melee and bring, you know, like a Karos top so I can tank some mage hits. And in between, I would try to flick Protect from Mage, while I dance the ball so I can reduce some damage. But this time, I want to try something completely the opposite. I want to use Protect from Mage. So I've heard some people actually, you know, trying this out, and they've told me they had some good results. So I want to try my own version of that. So this is the setup that I'm going to be doing for the Protect from Mage method. So the idea behind it is, with Protect from Mage, I will, you know, cancel the boss's magic attack. I will also cancel the boss's special attack, which is probably the most annoying damage thing you'll have to deal with, because it also reduces prayer. So I won't lose prayer at all, aside from just regular prayer tree. And also, I will completely negate all of the mage minion's attack, which is usually the minion that does the most damage. Now, the downside is that the boss, if he, you know, does melee you, he can hit up for like 47s, and yeah, his attack accuracy is pretty accurate, so I might run into a risk of him just comboing me, you know, with like constant 40s, but I'm gonna try this out and yeah, see what is up. I think this method has a lot of potential, so I'm very excited to mess around with Protect for Mage method. Yo, freaking Steam Battle Staff, dude. That's actually my second one. This is the first trip too, and I already got a drop, so that's pretty good. So this is the first trip, and if I could just hit, yes. Okay, then we are at 6 kills, but I do have to teleport now. But yeah, pretty good. I mean, 6 kills, you know, first try with this method. I gotta tell you, my strategy for this was very sloppy. My dancing was really, really bad. I haven't done God Wars in a while, so I definitely have a lot to improve. Dude, another Steam staff. What the hell is going on, man? So many Steam staffs already. And yeah, I still have so much more left to do on tasks, as you can see. Alright, that was a pretty good kill. Ooh, God Sword Shard too. Nice. Alright, I mean, it's my first God Sword Shard in ages. Not that I need any more blades, but that is just a bonus. This is a new best for me with this, you know, experimental setup, Protect from Mage. And as you can see in the KC, 66, so I've done 17 kills so far with the Protect from Mage setup. This is my best one. Steam Battle Staff again? What the hell, bro? Are you kidding me, dude? That's my third Steam Battle Staff. Wow. That's crazy. One food drop so far. Another God Sword Shard. Damn. Very nice. I need to start looking at my God Sword shard supply and see what we got in that. I haven't looked at it in a while. What do we get from this Master Clue? Here goes nothing. Oh! Samurai Greaves! Oh my god. No way. Wait, where's my other samurai stuff? Oh shit! Yo, that's so fucking hot. Oh my god, that's so sick. I need to take out the katana for sure, man, because this is Fashionscape on freaking fleek. Look at this level, guys. Freaking 98 mining. That's insane, yo. You know how slow Amethyst is? Like, I'm like hardcore AFKing this, so I'm probably getting only like 15k an hour. Just mining, but yeah, just tons of AFK. It works, you know, you get the XP, you get the levels. So it's time for me to pretty much, you know, make this very obvious. I'm pretty sure my next 99 is probably going to be mining, because, you know, during this school semester, I'm just going to be doing a lot more AFK. And yeah, I'm sure within this semester I can get the 99 mining. So look forward to that. It's one of the slowest 99s. If you AFK it, or one of the hardest ones if you choose to, you know, actively train it. So that's awesome. I can't wait to actually get this skill out of the way. I'm gonna miss mining though, you know, once I get a 99, but we still got a long ways to go. Oh my goodness, 140 greater demons. All right, I guess back to freaking Zami I go, man. All right, this is definitely the last kill of the trip, because I am out of antidote. Yeah, this is some crazy shit right here. I almost did 25 kills. That's insane. That beats my like previous best, even using, you know, the Protect for Melee method by a shit ton. by like at least 6 kills or something. So nice try, nice try. I did 22 kills that trip. That's awesome though. Wow, back to back 20 plus kills a trip. I'm really digging the potential in this method. So all right, this inventory will get me what, 73 XP left? Are you fucking kidding me? Because I'm about to get myself a nice level there. 87 rune crafting. So I did say I wanted to get around to doing the Karamja Elite Diaries. I could have done it starting at 86, but yeah, I kind of keep forgetting. But yeah, this time for sure, I'm going to go ahead and get this Karamja Elite done right now. Since I am, you know, doing a bit of Slayer again for the new 1000 KC goal, it would be nice just to have the Karamja Gloves for to get to Duradell very quickly. So there's only two things I have to do. See, I gotta craft 56 nature runes. That's why I needed the rune crafting. And create anti-venom. I'm already 99 herbalist, so that's super easy. So let's just get it done right away. Gotta go and get some stews and some orange spices. Try again. Oh, plus 5 rune crafting. Nice, dude. Very nice. In one try as well. So I'm gonna drop this real quick. Alright, just to check. 92 rune crafting. Okay, that should be all set. Yes. There we go. Hardest task done for the Karamja Elite. Rest is cake. Ah, there we go. Achievement diary. Done all the elite tasks now. Can I please get the upgrade? Let's check it out. There we go. Karamja gloves for, and of course, I get the lamp. So the biggest thing, obviously, with the elite diaries done is the Karamja gloves for, as I can teleport straight to Duradell. You know, before I had to go from gem mine to Duradell or had to use NPC contact, but yeah, for the rest of my Slayer, I will just use this glove now. So that's really, really awesome. And that means another achievement diary is done, leaving me with 3 left, which eventually will all be completed in due time. Nice. The recoil killed it, actually. That was pretty good. Dragonstone. Holy shit. Rare drop table strikes again. Alright, there we go. That is another Zami task completed. Basically a back-to-back task. But yeah, in this Slayer task, though, we had some amazing results with the Protect from Mage method. So that's really awesome. You know, like average kills was like borderlining constant 20s a trip, which is insane. So, and that is the 1300 task completed here on the account. Oh yes, that is sick. Hellhounds, bro. It's a good thing I remember to unblock these guys, because I need to do some Cerberus, man. So we got Cerberus at 793, so a good 200 and change to complete the 1000. So yeah, let's go and do it, man. Oh, anyways, I just hit 800 KC. Oh, elite clue scroll and a rune two-hander. I just started the trip. Oh, what the hell? What the hell? Is this the primordial crystal? That's what it is. Oh my god. I'll stay for one more kill, but yo, that's very nice present coming back here, man. I haven't done this boss in ages, and yeah, to start off, we got ourselves a primordial crystal. Damn! Alright, so let me see how many pairs of dragon boots I got. Okay, I got 7. I might as well just turn this into a primordial, so save some bank space. Yep, boy, now I have 3 of them in my bank. Just because why not, I guess. What the fuck? I just got a jar of souls. I'm actually kind of excited for that because I never gotten that before. And yeah, that's pretty much the only thing I didn't have from this boss. But yeah, now I pretty much have everything there is to have. Okay, so as far as I know, I can just put the jars in my house, so I can change it up whenever I want. So, oh, actually, let me configure that. Is there any way to do it? Jars? Oh, cool. Okay. So, as you can see, these are the 2 jars I got. Nothing else. But yeah, since This is new. I guess I'll put it as my default for now. Really cool. Oh, we should do a zoom in actually. Yeah, let's see what's up. Oh, that's so cool. Very nice.
All right, this is the last adamant dart tips, like forever, to be honest. Let me see how many adamant darts I got right now. 21,000. So I made like, what, 40,000, 20,000, something like that in the summer. I just never got around to making them all. So now I actually have them all made. So that's great. Anyway, speaking of darts, I've seen recently people have been trying out a lot of ranged methods at servers. So I want to try blowpipe servers, and of course I want to try the twisted bow servers. I've already have a fair, you know, idea of what like melee servers was like with my bludgeon, so I like to test out the range and see how each style fares. Just did a first kill with the blowpipe. I did bring the warhammer, as the blowpipe is a bit less accurate against this guy, so the warhammer I thought would help. But yeah, first kill with it seems to be really good. I killed the Cerberus, the first one, incredibly fast, so a lot faster than the bludgeon normally would kill it, so that's a good first sign impression. There we go. Alright, just finished the first trip with this. Ooh, nice summer pie. How many kills did we do with 6 prayer potions? 866. Okay, well, nice. With the adamant darts, blowpipe, and honestly, it felt easier than the bludgeon, even though I only did blowpipe, you know, one trip so far in my life. So, yeah, might just end up sticking to range the whole time. So I did 20 to 30 kills with T-Bowl as my primary weapon, and it's pretty good. It's actually about the same as the blowpipe. Also get around like 9 to 10 kills with like 5 to 6 prayer potions. So that's pretty good, although I feel like there's a lot more room for improvement. So I do see the range methods. I see that it has a lot of potential, you know, like for me to improve on it, more so than the melee method. Looking forward to testing out a bit more when I have another task. Oh shit, I just got an elite clue scroll. Okay. Alright guys, we'll take a little break from SERP again to do a little bit of clues then. Here goes nothing. Oh, wait a minute, Gloves of Darkness. Wait a minute, do I have that? I think I do have that. Yeah, I do. Because I remember one of the first ones I got was the gloves. I still am looking for the Road Topper Darkness so I can complete the Darkness set, so. Oh shit, I got another Elite Clue. Wow, that's crazy. That's 3 Elite Clues. Alright. So I just finished the Cerberus task, and that put me at 945 KC, so I just need 55 more. It's time to update the good old progress sheet, guys. So, two main things on the PVM item section. For Zami, I ended up getting 3 additional Steam Battle Staffs. So, I originally left Zami with 1, so that puts me at 4 now. And also, for Cerberus, which is on the Slayer section, I got myself a 3rd Primordial Crystal. Very valuable stuff here. And let's go on the bossing KC. So at Cerberus, I stopped around 950 or so, so I'm really close. And also for Zami boss, I got all the way up to 580 or so. And also I decided to add a jar section just because, you know, now that I have like more than one. So I'll be wrapping up today's video here, guys. Ended up being 20 minute video, even though I trimmed the hell out of all these clips, but yeah, that's good to make up for the extra delay. I've been pretty busy this past week, so it's been hard to actually have time to edit the video, but now it's here. So anyways, if you are new to the series, feel free to subscribe to the channel. That way you know exactly when the next video will come out. Other than that, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you guys soon with another video in hopefully a week. Take care.